guys, I am back with my friend's guinea pig, Weasley. Weasley, say hi. And guess whose guinea pig this is? Taylor! She's back again for another video with a cucumber for Weasley. Alright, so today, not only do we have an amazing guinea pig with us, we are going to be reacting to two sentence horror stories.
Where's my phone?
And yeah, go figure that out.
All right, so we are now doing the, let's have the title here, 15 creepy two sentence horror stories to terrify people with very short attention spans. Now that's the title right there. Okay, so the first one is, the grinning face stared at me from the darkness beyond my bedroom window. I live on the 14th floor.
Dun, dun, dun!
Or an uncreepy way to put it, someone's skydiving and they're falling to their death and they grab onto their window and smile at you.
That's obviously what happened.
First
totally.
Reaction.
Yeah. I think that's what happened. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Totally. Alright, now the next one, Taylor doesn't want to read because it's long.
I know I'll stumble and say something embarrassing.
That's okay. Okay, so I begin tucking him into bed, and he tells me, Daddy, check for monsters under my bed. I look underneath for his amusement and see him, another him, under the bed staring back at me, quivering and whispering.
That's
Daddy, there's someone on my bed.
This is my favorite.
I think
one.
The kid is on the bottom of the bed. That's kind of creepy though. Like, what if there is like another you under your bed?
Totally realistic. There's totally another you living under your bed at all times.
But
be
like,
aware.
Which one is the real kid?
The one?
Like, the imposter must be on top of the bed, and they're like,
that makes no sense.
No, it.
Okay. You're overcomplicating it.
True. Figure it out for yourselves. Let us know which
obviously the real kid is on top, and there's a shapeshifter thingy majigger under the bed.
Or the shapeshifter thingy is on top of the bed.
But why would that be your reaction if you were shoved under a bed by a shapeshifting monster? Daddy, there's someone on top of my bed. No, it wouldn't.
No, true. Alright, well, I guess there's there. There's there. Okay. Well, the next one is, sleep did not come to me easily that night. In the cabin, in the woods, her portraits on the wall only portrayed deformed and the decrepit. Sleep has never come easily to me ever again, for when I had woke, I found no portraits, only windows.
I'm confused. What does that mean?
So there were creepy people outside of the window who was like staring at him while he's sleeping, and their faces are like deformed, and that's creepy.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I don't find that creepy, because they've obviously gone away, or they're under your bed looking, they look like you.
Well, then that's more creepy. All right. There was a picture in my phone of me sleeping. I live alone. How does that work? Ow. So there's like an intruder who just comes in your room, steals your phone, and like takes a picture of you.
At least he didn't kill you.
Mm,
or did he?
Dun, dun, dun. Alright, the next one. No, I have braces. I can't bite on it. Alright. They delivered the mannequins in bubble wrap from the main room. I began to hear popping.
That's one of my favorite ones as well.
Mm-hmm. So the mannequins are living and they came out of the bubble wrap and they're popping it? Ugh, that's
or one of
creepy.
Your coworkers is popping the bubble wrap because it's fun.
Way to make it not creepy, Taylor. Thanks. This is actually kind of creepy, though, because we're outside. So,
and
like,
there are mannequins everywhere.
Mannequins. Mannequins everywhere.
Okay.
The longer I wore it, the more it grew on me. She had such pretty skin.
That one also confused me when I was reading through them. Does that mean that he, like, cut the skin off and, like, put it on him? Or
yes.
Is he, like, does he possess people? And, like, he's possessing the body.
True.
Possessing?
Wait.
What's the right word?
Possessing? Possess? It's possessing, I think.
Alright.
Yeah. Anyway, that's really creepy. And by the way, guys, if you have any creepy two-sentence stories, ideas, comment down below, and I will do a video of those if there are enough. So therefore, comment. Alright, next one. My daughter would not... Alright. My daughter would not stop crying and the screaming in the middle of the night. I visit her grave and ask her to stop, but it doesn't help.
You butchered that. So, but okay.
I know. Do you want to read it?
My daughter won't stop crying and screaming in the middle of the night. I visit her grave and ask her to stop, but it doesn't help.
So is she alive in her grave, or is it like her ghost or something?
Was her
she
ghost, like, obviously.
What if she was like buried alive, or maybe she like misses her family or something?
If she was buried alive, she probably would have been dead and people would have like dug her up, so
yeah.
She's a ghost.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Perfect. Lovely. Alright. Carol never wore her safety goggles. Now she doesn't need to. Wait.
That's also one of my favorites. I like how they're like.
Is she dead or did her eyes get like poked out?
Her eyes got taken out. With a spoon, obviously.
With a spoon. No, I think she's dead. Or, no, maybe her eyes got...
But like, what was the point of she never wore her goggles?
Then it must be the eyes.
Oh, that's creepy.
Oh, this one I've heard before. This one is super creepy. This is one of my favorite ones. Okay, are you ready? The last thing I saw was my alarm clock flashing 12:07 before she pushed her long, rotting nails through my chest. Her other
hand... So it's a girl Wolverine.
Muffling my screams. I sat bolt upright, relieved it was only a dream. But as I saw my alarm clock read 12:06, I heard my closet door creak open.
I didn't get that the first time, but I ruined it. That's really cool.
It's not cool, it's creepy.
It's really cool.
Like, wait. He like saw the future in his dream. Room a dream. Alright, here's this one. Okay. After working a hard day, I came home to see my girlfriend cradling our child. I didn't know which was more frightening, seeing my dead girlfriend and stillborn child, or knowing that someone broke into my apartment to place them there.
Obviously, that someone broke into your apartment to put them there.
So, did they like dig them up and put them there? I got chills. That's sad.
I got you.
That one's more sad. I feel like that one's more sad than
I
creepy.
Feel like you have the best reactions, and I'm just like...
Meh. You're like, okay, continue. Alright. My sister says that mommy killed her. Mommy says that I don't have a sister. I got chills again. Oh, that's so weird. So, the mom killed her and just told the kid that she didn't have a sister.
Or there's just a really creepy little girl ghost. It's like, I'm your sister.
That's also creepy. Anywho. When I finally grabbed her in the darkness, I swam back to the surface. It never occurred to me how fast the ice could freeze over.
That's like Jack Frost from...
So he like saved someone and then went up to the top and there was ice and he couldn't get back up, so therefore they both died?
It's like in Harry Potter. Except that Ron comes to save Harry. Spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert. Oh, well, that's okay. Next one. Don't be scared of the monsters. Just look for them. Look to your left. Look to your right. Under your bed. Behind your dresser. In the closet. But never look up. She hates being seen.
I don't think she can, like, be up in the sky.
Yeah, we're outside. We're good.
We're safe.
That's creepy, though, honestly.
Oh, hi, buddy.
There's a dog now. Woohoo!
Wahoo, wahoo!
All right, next one. The doctors told the ampute he might experience a phantom... hold on. Okay, let me restart that. The doctors told the ampute... I think that's how you say that. Like, someone who had something amputated. Ampute. Good enough. He might experience a phantom limb from time to time. Nobody prepared him for the moments, though, when he felt cold fingers brush across his phantom hand. I don't even know what to say to that.
I wish these were like book synopsises, because I would totally read those books.
Uh-huh, pretty much. All right, next one. Actually, this is the last one, unless you have another one.
No, I don't.
You hear your mom calling you into the kitchen. As you are heading down the stairs, you hear a whisper from the closet saying, "Don't go down there, honey. I heard it too."
We heard a different version.
Yeah, there was a different version in, like, another one of these that I was reading through earlier. So someone knows her then.
Or,
like, or they're just creepy stalkers who know their names.
Yeah.
Oh, that's creepy. Okay.
Or the dad isn't there, and the dad didn't say anything, so.
Maybe it's the dad.
Maybe the dad's evil.
Wait, I just realized.
What?
That could have been. The creepy part for that one could have been that the, like, girl said, "I heard it too." Or, did you just throw my phone?
No, I gently tossed it. Oh, actually, the creepy person might be that I heard it too. It might be like a shapeshifter person.
There are a lot of shapeshifter things in these.
Okay, well, before we go, we have one more creepy story. Two sentence one that we came up with ourselves.
You can say it.
Okay. Hold on, let me remember it. Oh, wait.
Me to say it?
No, I remembered it. Unless you have some creepy effect to put on it, go for it.
I mean, I'm a creepy person.
So. No, say it loudly. Projectify. Do you not remember it? I remember it.
It was something about a girl.
Oh, no. Okay, I'll say it. Alright, so I kept on telling them, I'm alive, but they buried me anyways. Ugh. Like, it's at someone's funeral, and, like, they have her in the coffin, and she's, like, yelling from there, like, I'm not dead, and they bury her anyway, which is kind of creepy. Alright, that is it for the video today. We hope you enjoyed, and we will see you guys later. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe!